So this is our reciprocating pump test rig. This is our main test section, and this one is our control panel. So in this test section, this one is some tank, or I can say, we can say measuring tank. It is made up of acrylic, and this one is our reciprocating pump. It runs along with this three-phase AC motor, and it is connected to this gearbox, okay, to reduce the RPM of the motor to that of the requirement of the reciprocating pump, okay. So this one is our suction line, and with suction valve, gate valve is installed, and this is vacuum pressure sensor that reads the vacuum pressure on the suction line, okay. Then it goes to the pump, and pump delivers to the, this is air vessel to reduce the fluctuation, and after this, through this delivery line, it goes back to the main line. So it is a recirculating system. On the delivery line, we have a delivery pressure sensor which reads the pressure in the bar in the delivery line. This is a gate valve to control the flow rate in the delivery line. We can increase or decrease the pressure as per our experiment. This is bypass valve. If the pressure in the delivery line exceeds above the given limit, we can open this valve and reduce the pressure in the line. Okay, and here in the delivery line, we have flow sensor. This reads the flow rate of water in liters per hour. Now, it is connected to this control panel. So, it reads pressure, vacuum, flow rate, RPM, and start, stop, and frequency to operate the motor. It is a variable type AC motor. And on the right side, we have a wattmeter reading, voltage, current, power factor, frequency, and watt. Currently, say I give the frequency of 40 here, enter, and I run. Now it is in running condition at frequency of 50 Hz. You can see. We can also vary the movement of piston using this arrangement given at the top of this pump. It is currently fixed at 90 mm length. Okay. Now, if I close this valve, the pressure in the line will start increasing. See, same goes for the vacuum line. Vacuum is created, hence it is going in the negative direction. Okay, corresponding RPM and the voltage reading is here. Hence we can calculate the efficiency of the pump as per the instruction given in the manual. Thank you.